There is a new book taking an inside look at the presidential campaign of Donald Trump. Written by a former Trump campaign and manager, Corey Lewandowski, and former deputy campaign manager, David Bossie. It's called Let Trump Be Trump, and Lewandowski says his boss ran a tight ship, leaving nothing to chance.
He demands such perfection, and he deserves it.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
We wanted that campaign to be perfect from the time the music was cued to the time he walked on the stage to the walked off, and the little things. He is so good at those little details.
Very interesting revelations now. Byron York, chief political correspondent, Washington Examiner, Fox News contributor. How you doing, Byron? Good day.
Good morning.
I saw some excerpts over the weekend. Mm-hmm. What do you think it tells us?
Well, this is the first really inside account of maybe the most incredible presidential campaign ever. And I think the title of it, Let Trump Be Trump, is very telling here because it refers to this battle inside the campaign between some advisors who wanted Donald Trump to tone down his act, to be a little more presidential, to just quiet down a little bit, and others, and Trump himself, who said, no, 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 gonna be myself. I am what I am. I turn it up to 11, and he won, and they won.
The title is interesting. Come back to that in a second. There was this exchange where the president, then a candidate, was ticked off at Paul Manafort. And they were flying on the plane. He asked the pilot to lower the altitude so he could call Manafort. And Lewandowski says part of that conversation went like this, okay? Just going to pull out one small quote. Tone it down? I want to turn it up. Now, just take that quote there. But Manafort was fired, so was Lewandowski, and we know that now. But those words, tone it down, I want to turn it up, I think that embraces who Donald Trump is more than anything, because he turns it up on everything, Byron.
He does. He does. And I think what the book shows is there'll be a lot of attention paid to some of the colorful stuff in it. But the fact was, Donald Trump was an unconventional politician who had an almost supernatural ability to connect with the voters that a Republican needed to be elected president. And so he had all of these advisors, none of whom had ever been elected president themselves, telling him he had to, you know, cool it, calm down, tone it down. And his instinct told him not to do that. And in almost every situation in the campaign in which he got in trouble, he would choose to double down or triple down, and he ended up getting elected. So that's where the Let Trump Be Trump thing comes from.
I'm going to read one more paragraph here that was put out, okay? Here it is. Sooner or later, Lewandowski and Bossie write, everybody who works for Donald Trump will see a side of him that makes you wonder why you took a job with him in the first place. His wrath is never intended as any personal offense, but sometimes it can be hard not to take it that way. The mode that he switches into when things are not going his way can feel like an all-out assault. It breaks most hardened men and women into little pieces, end quote. We're going to have them on later in the week here, but my impression of that campaign was a campaign that was living hour to hour. It wasn't day to day or week to week. I mean, they were really trying to figure it out as they went along. And I just wonder, I saw you on the trail so much, and I just wonder if that was your impression as well.
Oh, absolutely. It was being planned on the fly, but that was often in kind of a day-to-day sense. I think Donald Trump had a bigger strategic idea of how to appeal to Republican voters. He had an instinctive sense that Republican voters were disillusioned not only with Barack Obama, but with George W. Bush and the whole Republican establishment. Trump instinctively knew this. He's not a political scientist. He doesn't read a lot of political books, but he somehow knew this. And I think these two staffers, by the way, neither of whom followed Trump into the White House, understood that Trump had this supernatural talent.
Thank you, Byron. There's a lot in that book.
Thank you, Bill.
Appreciate the analysis in Washington. Thank you.